Good morning, students. Today we are going to see the last topic of materials management, that is material handling. Material handling is an important process in the production management, because without handling the raw materials, we cannot complete the production process completely. So today we are going to see the material handling objectives, principles and equipments in material handling. First, let us see the objectives of material handling. The first objective is the reduction in manufacturing time. If we handle the materials properly, we can reduce the usage of time used for production of materials. So, the material handling equipments used to reduce the manufacturing time. Second one is, we can reduce the labor cost. So, if the equipments are mechanized, equipments are used for material handling, the labor cost can be reduced. The number of labors employed in manufacturing process can be reduced. Then third one is better utilization of shop floor and warehouse. That is, the shop floor, that is the production area, the actual production taking place area is called a shop floor. The shop floor area can be effectively utilized if we use the proper material handling equipment. Then improvement in quality of product. The product quality can be improved if we handle the machine, handle the materials properly. If the materials are handled properly in an organization, the quality of output is definitely will be good. Then reduction in breakdown and work stoppages. If the human beings are used in production means, then if they are infected or if they are affected by any problem, they won't come to the production office, so production department. So then all the production process will be get stopped. If we use the mechanized material handling equipments, then the production will not be get stopped, or breakdown or stoppages of production can be avoided. The next one is increase in employee safety and comfort. If we use proper material handling equipments, the employee safety is confirmed, because the employee is not allowed to, should not allowed to take heavy loads. So we can protect employees by using effective material handling equipments. Next one is better control of flow of materials. So if we use the material handling equipment, there will be a proper flow of materials continuously. There won't be any stop, any stoppage or breakdown in the flow of materials. So we can use the material handling equipment for a continuous flow of production. There are two types of material handling equipments. They are fixed path material handling equipment and variable path material handling equipment. Fixed path material handling equipment means the materials are handled in a completely in a fixed path. That is, the material handling equipment cannot be moved to any other place. So it will be in a permanent place. So the materials will be moved from one place to another with the help of fixed path material handling equipment. Path means way, fixed way. So the materials will flow in a fixed way. That is called as fixed path material handling equipments. Then variable path material handling equipments means, if we want to move our products outside the organization, or if we want to move our products to top floor of the organization, at that time we need some other variable path material handling equipments. Variable path means we can change the path, way. So way can be changed from one to other. So that is variable path material handling equipments. So first let us see the variable path material handling equipments. Variable path material handling equipment, first one is crane. So the crane can be used in any place. For example, if a car is fall down in near the road, highways, means the cranes are used to lift the car from the place. Same way, the product from harbor, the ship make bring the product from other countries. So the cranes can be used to lift the product from the material from the ship, and it is placed in the lorry. So the cranes are the variable path material handling equipment. It can be taken to any place that is inside the organization or outside the organization or on the highways or inside the harbor, anywhere we can take the cranes. So it is called as a variable path material handling equipment. Next one is trucks. The trucks means there will be 3-tire trucks, 2-tire trucks. So the trucks means the trucks are used inside the organization to move the materials from one place to another place, from the godown to manufacturing area, or from the manufacturing area to warehouse, or from the warehouse to the customer place. So the trucks can be used to move the materials. There are forklift truck. Forklift truck means there will be forks in front of the truck, so it will lift the material, and the forks will be used to lift the material, and the lifted products will be moved to other place. So that is forklift truck. Next one is platform truck. There will be a platform in front of the truck. The materials are carried in the platform, and it is taken to other place, and it is kept there. Then highway truck. We all know the containers, trucks that are carrying materials from one place to another. So it is used in highways. Then hand truck. We can see this truck in making roads, road installation process. The hand trucks will be moved by the employees. They will be moving the hand trucks to taking the stones, cement, etc., sand, etc. Next one is pallet truck. Pallet truck means a truck which is having a box shape container. So inside that the materials can be kept, and it can be moved from one place to another place. Then next one is wheeled cart. Cart means that is vandi, thallu vandi, illana mechanically driven vandi. So the carts can be used, it can be used in any place. So it is called as a variable path material handling equipment. Next one is skids. Skids means there will be an rolling wheel in a particular table or chair. So in that table we can put the materials, and it can be pulled to any place so that we can use that material in some other place. So that is skids. Next one is dolly. So dollies, we may see dollies in hill stations. So if old age people who cannot climb the hills will be taken over the dollies in their shoulders. So that is like that in an organization, dollies are used to carry the materials from one place to another place. Dollies means ஆளெல்லாம் வச்சு தூக்கிட்டு போவாங்க மலை மேலே. அது மாதிரி நம்ம ஆர்கனைசேஷன்லேயும் ஒரு ரா மெட்டீரியலை ஒரு இடத்துலேருந்து கொண்டு போகிறதுக்கு டோலி மாதிரி ஒரு பின்னாடி ஒரு இது மாதிரி வச்சு முன்னாடி ஒரு ஆள் பின்னாடி ஒரு ஆள் சேர்ந்து அப்படியே தூக்கிட்டு போவாங்க. ஸோ தட் இஸ் டோலிஸ். நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் ஃபிக்ஸட் பாத் மெட்டீரியல் ஹேண்ட்லிங் எக்யூப்மெண்ட்ஸ். த ஃபஸ்ட் எக்ஸாம்பிள் இஸ் கன்வேயர். கன்வேயர், வி ஆல் நோ கன்வேயர் பெல்ட்ஸ். ஸோ த ரா மெட்டீரியல் இன் அன் ஆர்கனைசேஷன் வில் பி மூவிங் ஃப்ரம் ஒன் manufacturing process to another manufacturing process in a conveyor belt. The conveyor belt is a mechanical equipment. It will move continuously without stopping anywhere. So the raw materials or the semi-finished goods can be taken from one place for the other manufacturing process. So the conveyor is a best example. We can see the conveyor in cement manufacturing process. So the raw materials for cement manufacturing process are carried in a conveyor. Conveyor that will move from one workstation to another workstation. The raw materials will be taken and the semi-finished goods will be loaded, and that will move from one place to another place. Next one is pipelines. So pipelines are the best example for moving the liquid items, but it is a permanent fixed path material handling equipment. But the liquid items such as water, oil, petrol, diesel, that can be moved from one place to another place with the help of pipelines. Next one is fixed position crane. We can see this type of cranes in harbors. The harbors, the fixed position cranes are used to carry the material from the ship, and it will place it in the truck or it will place it in the lorry. So the fixed position cranes are the fixed in a particular place that is used to lift heavy loads. Next one is lift. So we all know there will be a lift in every organization or in every place, malls, hotels, hospitals, every place we have lift. It will carry people. So like the same way, the lifts are used to carry materials in manufacturing organization. The materials are carried from the lower base or ground floor to top floor with the help of lifts. So lift is a fixed path material handling equipment because the lift cannot be moved from one place to another place. It will be in one particular place only. So the materials are moved from top to bottom or bottom to top. The next one is gravity chute. Gravity chute means a circular way of bringing materials. So it will be fixed in an organization. அதாவது சருகல் மாதிரி இருக்கும். மேலே இருந்து கிராவிட்டியில் விட்டோம்னா அந்த ரா மெட்டீரியல் விட்டோம்னா அது சுற்றி கீழே வந்து இறங்கிறோம். சூட் அப்படின்னு சொன்னால் என்னென்னா சுழல். சரி, அப்படி சுழல் வந்து கீழே வந்து இறங்குற மாதிரி. ஸோ தட் இஸ் கிராவிட்டி சூட். த மெட்டீரியல்ஸ் தட் இஸ் புல்டு ஆர் புஷ்டு இன் தி டாப் is coming downwards in a circular way. Next one is hydraulic docks. We all know the docks தண்ணி அரைக்கிறதுக்கு ஒன்று யூஸ் பண்ணுவாங்க, புள்ளி. So that is hydraulic docks. Machineries are used to lift the materials from top to bottom. The hydraulic docks are used to lift the materials which is in lower or ground floor to the top floor with the hydraulic docks. If we are not able to pull the materials by manually, we can use this hydraulic docks, that is the equipments or machineries can be used to pull the materials from the ground floor to top floor. Next one is turntables. Turntables means if the conveyor is carrying the materials in a continuous path, at that time the materials has to be turned to the other direction. So the turntables you are used to turn the materials. It will the straight flow of materials is turned with the help of turntables. So it is fixed in a particular place. If the materials touch the turntables, it will turn the material. So the materials will flow to the other side of the production process. Next one is automatic transfer machine. This fixed path material handling equipments can be seen in car manufacturing area. That automatic transfer machine will be taking the equipments from one place to another place, and the assembling activities are done with the help of automatic transfer machine. Then next we are going to see the factors affecting material handling decision. So this is an important question, 10 mark question. Factors which are to be considered while handling the materials inside an organization. First one is type of production system. What type of production system we are going to use? There are two types of production system. They are intermittent production system and continuous production system. Intermittent production system means the production process will be carried out in different places. It will be carried out in different places, and lastly it will be assembled into one single process. But continuous production system means raw material is inserted in one place and finished products is the output in another place. For example, sugar manufacturing industry. Sugar cane is inserted into the raw material place, and it is moving to the next place. There the juice are taken. So sugar cane juice is taken. Then juice is moved to the next place. There the jaggery is made, and the jaggery is moved to the next place, and there the sugar is manufactured, and it is moved to there, and there will be an sacks for filling the sugar. So this is the continuous production system. So based on the continuous production system or intermittent production system, we have to choose the materials. Here for continuous production system, we can use conveyor, turntables, so automatic moving machine. So that and all we can use. But for a intermittent production system, we have to use trucks, cranes, and other variable path material handling equipments. The next one is type of product. So what type of product we are going to use in the production system is very, very important. First of all, if we are going to use the liquid item, liquid is the raw material for our production process, means we can use pipelines. So pipelines are used. If it is a gaseous item, means pipeline is the best way to carry the gas product from one place to another place. So gaseous products can be moved from one place to another place. And next one is solid material. Solid materials means like sand or stones, bricks, that can be moved from one place to another place. So we have to decide the raw material handling equipment based on the type of the product, what type of product we are going to use in our manufacturing process. So based on the type of the manufacturing type of the product, we have to select the material handling equipment. Next one is cost of material handling equipment. That is very, very essential, because we are handling the materials with the help of machine or men. So we have to calculate which is cheaper, whether men or machine. So after that only we have to decide whether what type of material handling equipment should be used. Then next one is forms of materials. So solid form, gaseous form, liquid form, semi-liquid form. Semi-liquid form are handled with the help of an closed container. So semi-liquid form, what type of forms of materials? Then bulky material. Bulky materials, the crane can be used to move the bulky materials. And then fragile material. Fragile materials are easy to purulkalna fragile materials. So it has to be handled very carefully. So that type of material handling equipments has to be used. And then these study materials. Study materials means semi-finished goods, like if example in a construction work, in a house construction work, the doors, window, that are study materials. They are semi-finished material that has to be carried in a different equipment. The next one is type of move, whether we are going to move our materials inside the organization or outside the organization. If you are going to you move the materials inside the organization, means there are different types of material handling equipment. If we are going to move our materials outside the organization, means there are different types of material handling equipment. So we have to decide what type of move we are going to do, whether it is an external move or internal move. Next one is type of plant layout. What do you mean by plant layout? Plant layout means arrangement of machine, material, men inside the production area is called as plant layout. Plant means a production, a factory or production area. So plant layout means arrangement of machineries, equipments, men inside the production area is called as plant layout. So based on the plant layout, we have to decide the material handling equipment. If there is a more space for the movement of material handling equipment, means we can use a big material handling equipment. If there is a very less space or very less layout for the movement of material handling equipment, means we have to use the simple machines for material handling. Then next one is type of safety. Last one is last factors to be considered in choosing the material handling equipment is safety. That is, the material handling equipment that is chosen should be safe to the employees, to the organization, to the machinery, to the product, etc. So safety is one of the important factors to be considered. So next we are going to see the principles of material handling. What are the principles we have to follow while handling the materials? So first principle is principle of minimum handling. That is, no handling is always better handling, best handling. That is, we should not handle the raw material too many times. Too many times means taking the raw material to one place and then to another place, to then another place, then the raw material will get collapsed or it will become a scrap. So we should reduce the handling of raw materials. The next one is principle of short move. Short move means we should not carry the raw material for a long way. It has to be moved to a short area, short distance. For that, we can locate our warehouse or godown nearer to the production place. So if we locate the godown nearer to the production place, means it is very easy to take the raw material from production place to manufacturing place. So it should not be taken a long way, because the time is waste, the cost is waste, The men efforts is waste. Next one is payload principle. Payload principle means if the raw materials are coming inside the organization, we have to load that lorry or truck with the finished products. So that is payload. If the material, if the lorry is coming and delivering the raw material and it is going empty means, but we have to pay the two-way cost. So both the cost we have to pay for getting the raw material and the empty traveling of the lorry to the particular place. So we have, in order to avoid the cost, we can use the lorry for delivering the materials or delivering the finished goods to the market. So the lorry which is bringing the raw material can be used to deliver the finished goods to the market. The next one is principle of avoiding partial tools. That is partly handled by machinery, partly handled by man. It is not at all good principle. So we have to avoid whether it has to be handled completely by the men or completely by the machine. So that is principle of avoiding partial loads. Avoid careful handling. That is, careful handling has to be done for the raw material, finished goods, etc. But careful handling has to be avoided for the scrap material. Scrap materials are no need to handled with the care, safety or handled with the care. So we can avoid the handling of scrap materials or unwanted materials carefully. The next one is use straight line move. Always use the straight line move for moving the raw material from one place to another place, because the circular way or circular flow, it will take time or it will use out the effort of the employees. So we have to avoid the circular flow or chutti varradu adala avoid pananum. We have to use the straight way for bringing the raw material from the godown to manufacturing area. Then one point we have left, use gravity whenever possible. That is, the gravity of force that can be used for bringing the material from top to bottom. So it can, we have to use whenever possible, we have to use the gravity for bringing the raw material from top to bottom. Then principle of avoiding partial loads. So partial loads means if the lorry is taken for delivering the finished goods from the manufacturing area to market, means it has to be filled completely. We should not partially fill the lorry. So it is the cost we have to pay is fully we have to pay. So at that time it is we have to incur more cost. So we have to wait or make the lorry to wait until the complete goods are filled in the lorry. The next one is use unit load principle, that is filling completely. Then avoid backtracking. It is very, very important principle, because the materials are went halfway in a truck. If we call the truck again, means it will come back. That is backtracking. It will take more cost, more time, more effort, etc. Everything is waste. So backtracking is waste one. For example, we can see people going paadhayathra poravangala nama paapo. So if nama oruthar munnadi vandu fast ah nadandu paadhayathra ki nadandu poitaaru appdin sonna avar konja dooram pona piragu dhaan paapaaru innum nama kuda vandavangala varalaye kaaname appdin sollittu avar enna cheyano andha time la thirumbi pinnadi vandu avangala thedi varakudad avar enna cheyano andha edathile wait pananum ivanga enna cheyvanga nadandu 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 anga vandiruvanga vanda piragu avar sendu polam. ஸோ இப்போ அவர் இன்னும் நிறைய தூரம் நடக்கணும், அதில் பாதியில் இவர் நின்று திரும்பி வந்தார் அப்படின்னு சொன்னால் அவரோட எஃபர்ட் ரொம்ப வேஸ்ட் ஆகும், பாடி பெயின் அதிகமாகும், அவர் பின்னாடி போகும்போது ரொம்ப டயர்டாயிருவார். ஸோ அதே மாதிரி தான் ஒரு கம்பெனியில் ஒரு ப்ராடக்ட் பாதி தூரம் போயிடுச்சு அப்படின்னு சொன்னால் திரும்ப அந்த ட்ரக்கையோ இல்லை அந்த மென்னையோ நம்ம என்ன செய்யக்கூடாது, திரும்ப நம்ம பேக் ட்ராக்கிங் பண்ணக்கூடாது. த நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் செலக்ட் மோர் ஃப்ளெக்சிபிள் மெட்டீரியல் ஹேண்ட்லிங் எக்யூப்மெண்ட். விச் மெட்டீரியல் ஹேண்ட்லிங் எக்யூப்மெண்ட் இஸ் யூஸ்ஃபுல் ஃபார் for us for that particular production. So we have to decide that, and then we have to choose the material handling equipment. It is one of the important principle. And then select material handling equipment with less dead weight. That is, the material handling equipment itself should not very heavy. So it we need more fuels to carry the empty material handling equipment. For example, the JCP or cranes are already very heavy. So we have to use the less weight material handling equipment. Then next one is combined movement and storage of material. Sometimes the lorry that brings the raw material will be asked to wait in the manufacturing area till tomorrow. We may not use that raw material to, or move that raw material to Gudon. For example, in Japan, they won't have many places to store the raw material. So they will be using a continuous production system. The raw material will come to the place of manufacturing area at the morning only, 9 a.m. So the manufacturing process starts by taking the raw material from the lorry, and after completing the manufacturing process, it will be again loaded in the lorry. This principle followed by Japanese is called as just-in-time management. Just-in-time management means the raw materials are never stored in the godown, or finished products are never stored in the godown, because already it is a small pieces of island. Japan is a combination of small pieces of island. So that island cannot be used for storing the raw material or storing the finished goods. So they use just-in-time management. So like that, we can use the trucks or lorry for storing the raw material also. The next one is use mechanical handling then manual handling. Mechanical handling means using trucks or lorry or anything to handle the materials. So mechanical handling will be very fast, will be very correct. The quality can be maintained. So the production may not get stopped, etc. So we have to use mechanical handling then manual handling. And then last principle is combine the movement and processing. We can see processing and movement. For example, in construction area, ஒரு பில்டிங் பண்ண கேட்டும் போது கலவை, அதாவது கலவை சிமெண்ட் இண்டஸ்ட்ரியில் நம்ம ஆர்டர் பண்ணோம்னா, அங்கேருந்து ஆர்ஆர் நகர்லேருந்தே சிமெண்ட்டு ஜல்லி மணல் தண்ணி எல்லாம் போட்டு அப்படியே மிக்ஸ் பண்ணிக்கிட்டே அந்த மெஷின் வந்து அங்கேருந்து இங்கே வரும். அந்த ட்ரக் வந்து அங்கேருந்து இங்கே வரும், அப்படியே மிக்ஸ் பண்ணிக்கிட்டே வரும். வந்த உடனேயும் அப்படியே கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ஷன் ஏரியாவில் வந்து அதை அப்படியே ஃப்ளோ பண்ணி விடுவாங்க. அப்புறம் மக்கள் வந்து இது பண்ணி விடுவாங்க. ஸோ பெரிய கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ஷன் ஏரியாவில் பெருசாக காங்க்ரீட் போடும்போது இந்த மாதிரி நம்ம மெட்டீரியல் ஹேண்ட்லிங் எக்யூப்மெண்ட்ஸை யூஸ் பண்ணலாம். மெட்டீரியல் ஹேண்ட்லிங் எக்யூப்மெண்ட்ஸு இந்த மாதிரி இதுக்கு வந்து இந்த கம்பைனிங் தி மெட்டீரியல் அது வந்துட்டும் இருக்கும், ப்ராசஸும் நடந்துகிட்டே இருக்கும், வரும்போதே ப்ராசஸும் நடந்துகிட்டே இருக்கும். பெஸ்ட் எக்ஸாம்பிள் இஸ் சிமெண்ட் மேனுஃபேக்சரிங் கம்பெனி வில் பி டெலிவரிங் தேர் சிமெண்ட் ப்ராடக்ட்ஸ் ஃபார் காங்க்ரீட் வித் த ஹெல்ப் ஆஃப் தி லாரி. இந்த லாரி வந்து எப்படி இருக்கும்னா, ஒரு பின்னாடி ஒரு பெரிய கேன் மாதிரி இருக்கும், அது சுற்றிக்கிட்டே வரும். வரும்போதே சிமெண்ட்டு மண் ஜல்லி எல்லாம் அப்படியே சுற்றிக்கிட்டே வரும், வந்த உடனே அப்படியே காங்க்ரீட் போடுறதுக்கு ஈஸியாக இருக்கும். ஸோ இந்த மாதிரி மெட்டீரியல் ஹேண்ட்லிங் எக்யூப்மெண்ட்ஸ் அவங்க யூஸ் பண்ணணும். ஸோ தீஸ் ஆர் தி வேரியஸ் பிரின்சிபிள்ஸ் வி ஹாவ் டு கன்சிடர் வைல் சூஸிங் தி ரைட் மெட்டீரியல் ஹேண்ட்லிங் எக்யூப்மெண்ட். Thank you, students. Let us see in the next subject or next topic. Thank you.